Ethan? Find him. Could you?
He hides too well, and if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
You found me! Well done, Ryan. Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Geralt to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the Wall. I'll miss Geralt. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Geralt is smart.
No one will tell me what Geralt did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you. But I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland, for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
And he calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself. After all, you are the lord of the house now.
He doesn't know me or what I'm capable of.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man. He taught Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asha. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I promise, I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
We'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
But since you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
That's not how it works.
Well, that's how it should work. You are the lord.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family. Lord Whitehill is a mean old man anyways.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
Your business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
I can handle Lord Whitehill.
Well said, my lord.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got 5 times as many men, and the backing of House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house.
Thank you, Lord Whitehill.
My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself. I've been waiting for this day all my life.
My father died a hero, fighting for the North against traitors and oathbreakers.
Aye! And look where that got him. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord? You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roose Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished! Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
No reason? You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the lord of this house.
We lost people too, Lord Whitehill. Your men murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the fucking coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
I took care of it. He received his punishment and it's done. He's gone.
What? Gone? That was my justice to deliver, boy, and you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this... this is not over!
It's over when my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
We're in the right, Lord Whitehill. Remember that.
Your son did well, my lady. He kept his wits while Lord Whitehill lost his temper. A lesser man would have been rattled, but Ethan here held his ground.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once. Your sister can help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
Ich hoffe, ich habe mich richtig behauptet bei dem Whitehill-Typen. Das war ein bisschen tricky.
Ethan made this for me. Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos. It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena. Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can. Wonders Made by Man, by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday. King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironrath today.
It troubles me to even ask this of you. But you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally. Especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but are you all right? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
It's kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady. You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
It's widely known that I work for Lady Marjorie.
I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but...
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know. Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss. From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
I need your help, my lady.
Of course, and I will help you in any way I can. But there's another matter we must attend to first. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford. Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor. She was very pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
How did you respond?
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens. That you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear. See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us. You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Good luck.
Oh Gott. Keinen Fehler machen, ja, da bin ich ja der Richtige für. Na super.
You can do this.
Jetzt die Frage, ob ich mich gleich verstelle. Wenn das so ist wie im.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace?
Wie sagt man, die beste Lüge ist die mit ein wenig Wahrheit.
With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Your Grace.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. you may rise.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, your grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, your grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
They were the Wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Perhaps too clever for her own good.
The girl did name Joffrey as the one true king.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Roose Bolton also served the Starks, your grace.
And proved his loyalty to the crown by bringing their house to a swift and sudden end. Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Our talent is unrivaled, Your Grace. Forrester Ironwood is highly sought after in the Seven Kingdoms.
So I'm told. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
I won't dishonor myself, Your Grace.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
would... Let the girl answer the question.
My loyalties would never conflict, Your Grace.
That's a coward's answer. I will not have my time wasted by a northern girl who thinks she can play games. Who do you choose?
The king, of course.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
Guck nicht so, hab ich jetzt was Falsches gemacht? Ich hab gedacht, ich hätte am besten geantwortet. Scheiße. Hätte ich was anderes gemacht? Ab in die Kommentare.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
These are trying times, my lord. My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the north.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. That certainly took courage, to so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Marjorie was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I was trying to appease her.
I think that was clear to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
You can help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Marjorie might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous.
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you? I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It's more than a little intimidating.
It went well.
Really? That's a relief. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime. I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour. Which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
You'll get us in trouble.
We're just having some fun. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen? He does have a certain look about him, and he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match! Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
It doesn't matter what you feel. It only matters what you say.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Cyrah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her. Go on. Ask.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you, and I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise. But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady! King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa.
Please, Lady Margaery, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Myra. If Cersei were to find out...
You're the only one who can help me. You have power over him, Lady Margaery, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Come on.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.